Welcome to our Food and Nutrition Services application for free and reduced meals support tutorial. We want to support you as you complete the application for your child to receive free or reduced meals for the upcoming school year. It is important that you complete the application as early as possible to ensure that your application is received and processed early in the school year. You may have seen these flyers at the meal distribution sites. These flyers have the website to begin your application today. We will begin at the website MySchoolApps.com. What do you need to know before filling out the application? You need to know your household income, the amount of money all of your family members make before any taxes are taken out. That is called the gross income. You need to know your child's name, school, grade, and birth dates, an email address and phone number, your actual address where you live, and your social security number if you have one. To start the application, I'm going to the website MySchoolApps.com. This application is available in multiple languages. Notice the language tab that's up here. So you can click over to other languages. The first thing that I will do is enter my zip code to find Montgomery County Public Schools. So I'm going to enter this zip code and search. And I'm going to select Montgomery County. That's my district. And now I can begin the application process. When I click on this, it will begin. I must accept the terms of use. Agree to the terms. And now I'm ready to start my application. I'm going to enter my name. For this purpose, I've made up a name, and my name is going to be Myra Lou. So I'm going to enter my name, Myra Lou, and today's date has already been entered, so I will click Save and Continue. This chart tells me the cost of the meals for elementary school, middle, and high school for the meals. I can read some frequently asked questions about eligibility guidelines by scrolling through here. I'm going to select whether my household has any of these meal benefits. For today, I'm going to select my household does not receive such benefits, but you have these other choices. So now I'm ready to enter my address. And for today's purposes, my address is 111. Rock Drive, and I live in Rockville, Maryland, and there's my zip code, so I will save and continue. I'm ready to add a student. So my first child's name is Mindy Lou. So I'm going to enter Mindy Lou, and I'm going to enter her birth date, and I'm going to say that she was born in April 19th, and she was born 2013. And she's a female. She's not a foster child. If you know the student number, you can enter it here. I will leave it blank. I will enter my child's school. I'm going to just select Arcola, and I'm going to say that she is in second grade. Save and continue. On this page, I need to enter Mindy's income. Mindy is a child, but she still might have income from child support or Social Security. I can enter the income here, or I can select no income. I will continue entering my students by clicking Add Students. For today, I'm going to say I'm done adding students. This page asks me if I have children who are not school-age children. So my younger children, if I have them in the house, I will enter that information by selecting Add Child. Otherwise, I will select Done Adding Children. On this page, I will need to enter the last four digits of the Social Security number, if I have one. If I don't, I will select Don't Have One and save and continue. We are almost done. On this page, I need to enter my income or any members in my family. So I'm going to add income. It will remind me to add income. So I want to add my income. I'm going to say that I'm going to enter $500, and that's every week. And I'm going to say those earnings are from work. Save and continue. And I am finished. So I'm going to say done adding income. If I have other family members, I would add that. I would add my husband's income. I will add my husband. His name is Mark. Lou. I will add his income. And he has $300. And that comes from, let's say it's weekly. And I will say, work. Save and continue. And now I'm done entering income. All right, I'm finished adding household members. And now I need to enter some information so that I can be contacted. So I'm going to enter my email address. I will read this information here. This is optional. I can say that I am not Hispanic. It's all optional. Save and continue. Review and sign your application. We're almost done. So you're going to read through to make sure that you've entered everything that you need to enter. And then you're going to certify that this is what you have entered is correct. And you are going to enter your name to show that you are signing the application. And I will submit my application. You will receive an email, or a letter in the mail that lets you know in about a week if your application has, if your child qualifies. That's it. You have successfully completed and submitted your application for free and reduced meals. You may also use a paper form to apply for free and reduced price meals. However, if you complete the application online, the process is much faster, ensuring that your child will have access to free meals as soon as possible. The online application has less room for error, and the process will be slowed down because someone is unable to read your handwriting on the paper form. The online form requires all information before moving on, so it is impossible to accidentally skip questions, which sometimes happen when you're using the paper form. Whichever you decide to use, choose only one. Either use the paper form or use the online application. The paper form cannot be printed. You must receive a paper form from your school if you choose to use the paper form. Your school will have a small supply of paper forms. Contact your school if you wish to use the paper form. If you need further assistance completing your application for free and reduced price meals, reach out to your school. They are ready to support you.